everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Pac-12 expansion has only enhanced this conference's credibility on a national scale. New coaches bringing great new innovative ideas, particularly on offense, gives this league an opportunity for a showcase like we're about to enjoy. That's going to do it for us. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming right at you. Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I are back at halftime.
See how these two teams play in this game as they prepare for the opening kickoff.
And this season is officially underway.
Vaughn has it at the 5. He's out to the 30. And he just got drilled.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Quick strike, and he drops it.
Jackson's intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 to go.
Ball on the 32. They'll bring him down at the 46.
Excellent job by this young quarterback of making the defense pay for bringing both outside linebackers. That's composure right there.
He's on the run, and they got him.
I think the quarterback here, even though he came up with a sack and he's on his back, he's also guilty here of not getting a better pre-snap read. You know, a lot of quarterbacks would get caught up in their size and their arm strength and how they throw the football, but the really good quarterbacks bring the intangibles to the table, and that means recognizing a blitz and affecting the offensive line and making the right call to adjust the protection. That time, he didn't do that.
So it's second down and 13 yards to go following that quarterback sack. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Got hit and still completed it. And they'll get him in the backfield. That'll be a loss of one.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
That'll bring up fourth and 13.
Doty, back deep to return. And down he goes at the 28-yard line.
The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game.
After a decent pickup, and he keeps it on the option play and picks up 6.
That'll make it 2nd and 4.
It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds.
First down.
Down he goes.
Right around the 44-yard line.
That brings in second and nine.
There's a strike complete. And they push him out
right around the 32-yard line.
That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Gains his way to the 19-yard line.
What is going on with this defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
There was just no way anybody could catch up with that pass.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 19-yard line, second down. Hit in the backfield. Loss of one there for the halfback.
That makes it third and nine.
He's under pressure. Would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Quick release, tight end, incomplete. Unable to pick up the first down, and the ball will change hands.
Great play there by the D. It's early in the season, but they showed they don't get rattled at all. I give them a lot of credit.
I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Tackle made at the 18-yard line.
Loss of two on the play. That'll bring up second and 12.
From their own 18-yard line, second down. And they make the stop around the 29-yard line. Receiver.
Run was his intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up fourth and one.
Jones awaits the snap. And he muffed it. He just couldn't pull that one in clean.
And Brad, that's what happens when you take your eyes off the ball. This was an error that should have been avoided.
They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. Anderson on the run. Runs outside for a nice gain.
Gain of five on the play. That makes it second and six.
Taken down right around the 34. From their own 34-yard line, third down. Quick throw out to the receiver. Tackled right around the 46-yard line.
Makes the tackle at the 46. 36-yard line. First down.
Before it can go anywhere.
Gain of 9 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 2.
Mike 51.
Fires complete over the middle. Brought down at the 34-yard line.
Gain of 11 yards. That makes it 1st and 10.
Taken down at the 33-yard line. We've played one. Still no score. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Tries to buy some time. He's tackled
at about the 29-yard line.
I think the play call was the right one by the offense. I just think the defense made a better play. They seem to want it more here on this big third down. Offense comes up a little bit short to set up a fourth down, but give all the credit to the personnel on the defensive side of the ball.
He heaves it to the end zone. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now.
56, 56.
Looking for his man, incomplete. From their own 29-yard line, it's 2nd down. To about the 41-yard line. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, 5 wide receivers. And he's tackled around the 48-yard line. Forward to about the 46.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. He makes his way to about the 32. Intercepted.
Pratt, he drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
2nd and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. He scrambled. They'll bring him down at the 25-yard line.
Ready? 45.
Now he scrambling. And he's going to be sacked.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
That'll make it fourth and six.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down.
Sure about that play call as they fail on fourth down.
That's a big time stop here by the defense. I know we're only in week one, but this defense looks like they're in midseason form.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
To get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offensive worst nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play. And as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of him. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
So the sack makes this a second and long. Throw, and down he goes around the 35-yard line.
It really wasn't badly played by the defense, but sometimes a good throw and catch just beats you.
Flips it middle to a running back. That's a great tackle at the 37. A couple of yards that time on the screen.
It's a nice play by the defense to shut down all the lanes, so this halfback wasn't able to make anything happen on that play.
Swanson to punt. He's to the 40. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line.
Almost halftime, Herbie, and we're right where we started.
Yeah, but if one of these offenses can get one explosion play, that might open things up for them.
This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime.
Looks middle, got his back. There's a very impressive open field tackle. Doty is back deep to return. Brought down the 19-yard line.
Both defenses really played well so far.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
He's scrambling. Slides down to the ground.
That makes it 7-6.
throws it to the halfback on the screen.
He's pushed out of bounds
around the 34-yard line. So at the end of the half, no score here.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Keith Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Maybe the most important statistic from the first half, no turnovers for either team. So far, a good job of ball security, but now you wonder if the quarterbacks can avoid putting the ball in jeopardy. They're going to want to make a big play, and that might sort of set off a feeding frenzy on the defensive side.
Yeah, and it's in defenses, that's the number one priority. I mean, you can give up a lot of yards. They can chew up yards up and down the field, but if you can force turnovers, then you're keeping them off the scoreboard, and that's your number one goal. So defenses, they have to be a little bit upset right now, and they got to try to find ways to hit harder. How about when you're tackling? Use the strip stick, you know, be able to strip the ball out, get the ball out, try to get some interceptions, try to make some user picks, you know, do whatever you can to try to get the football back from that offense and set your offense up in good field position.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if it got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
Great first half. Hopefully the second half's as good. He's to the 20. And he makes it out to about the 4-yard line. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. Gets out to around the 38.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. That makes it first and 10.
And he's hit immediately.
Thompson makes the tackle at the 39-yard line. First down.
On the catch. Oh, they strip it out.
Jackson is the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 49. The sub package in there defensively in this 5-wide receiver set. And he's tackled right away.
Meeks with the tackle at the 37-yard line. First down.
So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers.
Easy, back five, easy. Back five.
And a quick throw. Tackle made at the 27-yard line.
Gain of 10 yards. That makes it first and 10.
They come out in a 5 wide set. Flares it and almost had it intercepted. From the 27-yard line, it's second down. Scrambling around, looking for the corner. Inside the 10. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
The offense coordinator right now is very happy with the execution. That's the 5th first down on this drive alone. The big thing is when you have this kind of drive going, you don't want to end it in a field goal. Now you want to focus on trying to put the football into the end zone.
He steps out around the 4-yard line.
Just timed the snap count there and really made a nice play.
That makes it third and goal.
third down. They need 8 yards here to get the ball in the end zone. Gets it out in a hurry. Colorado State could take the lead with this field goal. He gets it up, and they tack on 3 points. Reese Davis joins us in the studio with this update. Reese?
Let's see what's happening in the top 10. And for FSU, they're trying to win their first game of the year. And for Wheeler, he scored a touchdown. Florida State has the edge, 21-14, middle of the third quarter.
And we thank you, Reese Davis. Back to the action here. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Colorado State's coaching staff will go out tonight. I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
And they make the stop around the 19-yard line.
When you're an option quarterback, you get used to getting popped pretty quickly. He'll bounce right back up.
That makes it second and 14.
Second down, 14 coming up here. Ball on the 19-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. He's out to the 30. He's taken down at the 31-yard line. He's to the 40, and he hits him hard. Receiver. He gets hit out of bounds at the 42-yard line.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want them.
56, 56.
Go, D. Let's go.
Ready. Play 90.
90. Nice run up the middle.
Second and 6.
56,
56.
Delta.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackle at about the 33-yard line.
Brings him down at the 33-yard line. That'll bring up 32.
56, 56. Easy, 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 easy. Over.
He's on the run. He's got the corner. Brought down at the 24-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Utah.
He's
splits the uprights with the extra point. It was an 11-play, 78-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize the defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
Utah, the kick. Doty fields it at the 7. They'll bring him down at the 25. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Gets to about the 27-yard line. Gets out to about the 44-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. First down.
He's tackled around the 42-yard line. From their own 42-yard line, second down. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation. Caught, enough for the first down, and he's taken down at 39.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
They come out in an empty backfield. He's got it with room to run. He's hit and taken down. So at the end of 3, Utah in front, 7-3. Great 3 quarters of action, tight ball game, and now it's the 4th quarter, and this will decide it. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And he's tackled at about the 19-yard line.
Makes the tackle at the 19-yard line. That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
He might have a chance. They'll bring him down at the 7-yard line. He fights forward to about the 7. The offense that takes the field on 4th down. Gonna run for it, but he can't get away. Defense stiffens on 4th down, and the ball will change hands.
That's a big-time stop here by the defense. I know we're only in week 1, but this defense looks like they're in mid-season form.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Utah is up by 4. He gets out to about the 6-yard line. carries to the 20. He's out to the 30. And they finally knock him out at the 36. That was a huge lift.
Brad, you're right. A run like that can really get the momentum rolling.
Some time.
Tackle made right around the 42-yard line.
And they make the stop at the 48. Out to about the 48-yard line. Now he's scrambling. He's taken down around the 46-yard line.
Good coverage by the defense, but they have to be aware of this quarterback's tendency to scramble around and pick up some yards.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Just over 2 minutes in the game. They got to him, and he did not get the first down. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
The Rams are going to call their second timeout.
He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. You look up at the clock, Herbie, and there's not a lot of time to make something happen here.
No, it's been ugly for both of these offenses. You got to think about maybe spreading out the defense, giving your quarterback a chance to either run or throw. Somebody's got to make a play here to determine the outcome of the game.
Throws it, and oh, he dropped it. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 20. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Tackle at the 34.
Gain of 14 yards.
Hey, kill, kill, kill! Black 5, black 5! Go, go! Green 9, green 9! Go!
Wants to throw outside.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on 34. Throws to the tailback, incomplete.
This running back runs outstanding routes out of the backfield. But that pass was a little too out in front of him.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. He wants it all. Doesn't get there.
Sure, it's disappointing, but this is the kind of mechanical flaw you can fix with practice and coaching.
So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Just under two to go in the game. Should do it. A fourth down stop here late in the fourth quarter, and that should be the nail in the coffin in this game. Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? Tackled after a decent pickup. Mueller gains about 4 yards on the play. The Rams using their third and last timeout. Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 35. And he shoved out of bounds at the 21.
Run, run, run.
got 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Nice run there as they work the outside. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had. And the ball game's over. The Utes get the victory, 7-3. That wraps things up for us. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.